गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट, माय सेल्फ गणक सर फ्रॉम सर्व शक्ति विद्यानिकेतन मालदा स्कूल। ओके फ्रेंड्स, वी आर लर्निंग मैथ्स सब्जेक्ट फॉर द सेवंथ स्टैंडर्ड। ओके सो इन टू आवर मैथ्स सब्जेक्ट वी हैव स्टार्टेड फिफ्थ नंबर चैप्टर दैट इज ऑपरेशंस ऑन डेसिमल नंबर। सो बिफोर दैट वी हैव सीन टू लेक्चर्स ऑन द सेम चैप्टर दैट इज ऑपरेशंस ऑन डेसिमल नंबर। Into that we have seen what do we mean by rational numbers. Rational number means the numbers which are similar to the rational number. So the number which contain numerator and denominator, that numbers are nothing but the rational numbers. Okay. So various operations we have to see on the rational numbers. So which are the operations which we can perform on the rational number? Four operations. First one, addition, subtraction, multiplication and division. Okay, so that's are the four operations which we can perform on the rational number. Out of that, two operations we have seen into the last lecture, that is addition of rational number and subtraction of the rational number. So into the today's lecture we are going to see multiplications and multiplicative inverse of the rational number. So that two topic we are going to see into the So, for the revision purpose, we will again take one example of addition and one example of subtraction of rational number. So, if I want to take any rational number, how I will take the rational number? Rational number means one is numerator. Suppose at the numerator I will take 5 and at the denominator I will take the 7. So, that is one rational number. Now, second rational number, suppose I will take 3 by suppose I will take here 3. So 3 by 3. Now I have that two rational numbers, 5 by 7, 3 by 3. Now first question is like that, add the following rational number. Add the following rational number. Rational numbers are 5 by 7, 3 by 3. 5 and 3 are numerator, 7 and 8 are denominator. So if I want to add that numbers, what will be the process? As we see into the last lecture, if I want to add the rational number, what I have to take? Add the numerator and denominator, two things will come. So, add the numerator, what I will take? Cross multiplication of numerator, denominator, numerator, denominator. So, first cross multiplication 5 into 8. And as I have to do the addition of that two rational number, I will do the addition. Then, second numerator is 3 and denominator is So that is nothing but the numerator of our answer. And at the denominator, what I have to take? Multiplications of denominator simple. So which are the denominator? 7 into second denominator 8. So 5 8 are 40 plus 3 into 7, that is 20, divided by 7 into 8. 50. Here I have to add both the number. 1 plus 0, that is 1. 2 plus 4, that is 6. So 6 by 56 is nothing but the addition of the two rational numbers. Now second question is like that. Subtract. And again same numerator. 5 by 7, 3 by 3. Now if I want to subtract, that is two rational number. What I will do? As seen into the last lecture, we will do the same process. So again, for the answer, numerator and denominator are same. So at the numerator, what I will take? Cross multiplication of the numerator denominator, numerator denominator. But as I have to do the subtraction, so instead of that addition, I will give the subtraction sign. So cross multiplication, 5 into 8. Now I have to subtract, so I will give the minus sign. And again 3 into 7. At the denominator, like the addition, I will take the multiplication of denominator. So 7 into. Okay. So 5 8s are 40 minus. So 3 7s are 21 divided by 8 7s are 56. So 40 minus 21. Answer is 19 divided by 56
is our answer. And here for the addition, 61 by 56 is our answer. Okay, that means this from this example you will get the detailed idea about the addition of the rational numbers. Okay, so for the addition, the change for addition and subtraction is only that into the first multiplication you have to take addition and subtraction. Denominator is same. At the denominator, I will take the product of denominator of both the rational numbers. Okay. So that is the addition and subtraction of the rational number. Now into the third now, after the subtraction, third question may be like that. On the rational number, we have to perform third operation, that is multiplication. So question may be like that, multiply, and the rational numbers are like that. So now before multiplying, we have add these numbers, also we have subtract this number. Now into the today's lecture we have to see how to multiply two rational numbers. Okay. So for the multiplication, I will arrange that first. 5 by 7 multiply 3 by 8. Now that two numbers, what I have to do? Multiply. So for the multiplication, it is very simple process. Multiplication, add the numerator, add the denominator. At the denominator, you have to take the multiplication of the denominator, because due to the addition and subtraction, we have at the denominator, we have also taken the multiplication of the denominator. So denominator will be same. So for the numerator, at the addition, we have taken cross multiplication, addition of cross multiplication. For the subtraction, we have taken subtraction of cross multiplication. Now for the multiplication, simply we will take the multiplication of numerators. Which are the numerators? 5 and 3. So simply as the numerator, we will take the multiplication of numerator. So 5 3 is 15 and 7 8 are 56. So 15 by 56 is the answer of multiplication of the numerator. On the same numbers, same rational number, we have addition also, then we have performed subtraction also, and at the third question, we have multiply also that rational numbers. Okay? That means all three operations we have performed on the same rational numbers, that is addition, subtraction, multiplication. So for the more practice, we will take more examples of the multiplication of rational numbers. So from your book, page number 36, there are practice set 20. So first question we have taken, that is addition of rational number. Second question, subtraction of rational number also we have taken. Now from the third question, we will take more example related to the multiplication. So first example we will take, and fourth example, third example we will take. First example we have taken that multiplications of positive rational. Now, more example, that is third example. The rational numbers are like that, minus 8 by 9 multiply 3 by 4. Okay? Minus 8 by 9 is the first rational number, and second rational number is 3 by 4. That are the two rational numbers. What we have to do? Multiplication. So for the multiplication, at the denominator part we will take simple product of denominator. So first denominator is 9, second denominator is 4. So at the denominator I will take the product of denominator. Now at the numerator, as here is the multiplication, I will take the multiplication of numerator. For subtraction, I have taken the cross multiplication, subtraction of cross multiplication. For addition, I have taken addition of the cross multiplication. So as I have to do the multiplication, I will take the multiplication of numerator. So first numerator is minus 8 multiply, second numerator is 3. Now we have seen the rule for addition of the numbers. Okay, integer. So minus 8 is here and 3 is here. So if the alternate sign or different sign are there, which sign you will give to the answer? Obviously minus. If same sign are there, we will give positive sign or plus sign to the answer. But here 8 contain minus sign and 3 contain positive sign. That means two different sign are there. So I will give minus sign to the answer. So 8 threes are 24. So minus 24 is the answer. Okay. So at the denominator, what I have to take? Product of denominator. First denominator is 9, second one is 4. So I have to take product of 9 and 4. So 9 fours are 36. Okay. So what will be the answer of our multiplication? That is minus 24 by 36 is the answer. Okay. Now I think all of you understand that example. One more example we will take. Suppose fourth number example, 0 divided by 6 multiply 3 by 4. Now as I want to do the multiplication, what I will do? At the denominator, product of denominator, so 6 into 4, and at the numerator, 0 into product of numerator. So at the denominator, 6 4 is 24. But now at the numerator, 0 into 3. What will be the answer? 0 into 3. If I multiply any number by the 0, answer will be the 0. So here at the numerator, I will write 0. So 0 by 24 is the number. But if any number is multiplied by 0 or divided by 0, answer will be again 0. That means here answer is 0. That 0 is not rational number. So that means like that you can solve the multiplication of the rational number. Okay. So into the next lecture we will see multiplicative inverse and division of the rational number. Okay. Remaining question you have to solve at the home. Okay, thank you friends.